Welcome back to my channel. So in this video, I'm going to share with you all about psoriasis and its management. So what could be done apart from medication to get rid of psoriasis? So let's get started. Psoriasis is a condition wherein the aging of the skin becomes faster. That means generally it occurs in each and every human being, but we are not generally aware of that because it happens so unnoticingly. That means the old cells wither off and the new cells take their place. It occurs without our knowledge. But in psoriasis, due to some unknown reasons or say unknown etiology, which is commonly found in medicinal language, we don't know why it is happening, but the new cells or say the skin cells become or say wither off very fast. So the old cells can't take the place of the new cells at the equal faster pace. So in the meanwhile, the old skin cells, after withering off, the raw surface of the skin is left out like that only. So in that position, you see there is a raw, you know, silvery kind of scales are found on the skin. It's a really painful condition, psoriasis is. And the cause is where your immune system is attacking your own self. So that is pretty much unknown currently, like why it is happening. Though many theories have been done, it may be due to stress, it may be due to food triggers, something like that. I guess cause can only help up to some extent. The solution can only be found after properly understanding and assessing what could be done for that. So after my own individual relentless research and going through so many articles in PubMed, which is PubMed is a place where you can find many research articles. So after going through many research articles, I found that specifically in PubMed, the some things which I never knew. So even I applied these principles onto my patients and I found really good results. So I thought, why not make a video on this? So some eliminating some things gave relief to the patients in psoriasis, and addition of some things gave very good relief to the psoriasis patient. So what are they? So after eliminating, first thing was alcohol. After eliminating, people really found a good relief after eliminating alcohol from their diet. And not only alcohol, second thing is gluten. Gluten, that means, which is found in wheat, rye and barley and oats, you know, these are the things wherein gluten is found. So eliminating gluten from diet also gave a good relief to the patients. And also eliminating of nightshades, that is like tomato and potato and also peppers from the diet, gave a good amount of relief to the psoriasis patients. See, the cause is not known. I guess it will be bad even to just lament on the fact that they can't eat this for whole life. At least they have found some solution, right? Staying away from these things is giving good amount of relief. I guess that is a great time, and that's the time to celebrate, okay? And so also not only that, addition of omega-3 fatty acid rich food that is found in the form of flax seeds, chia seeds, walnuts, and also good amount of fats, good amount of vegetable fats. Not the processed oils, but vegetable fats that is found in the form of avocado. Avocado is a fruit, but that is also rich in good amount of saturated fat. So I don't want to make it a complex subject, but you find this good amount of fats in nuts and seeds. So try to include these kind of diet or say nuts and seeds in your diet more. And not only that, addition of vegetables, raw vegetables or say steamed vegetables specifically, give some good relief for the patients. And not only that, vitamin D rich food, and apart from that, oral vitamin D supplementation also gave very good relief for psoriasis patients. So not only these, the triggering factors were generally found to be sugar, alcohol, and as I said, gluten, and also milk and milk products were found to be triggering the psoriasis flare up. And not only that, as I already mentioned, lack of exercise or say static or sedentary work was also found one of the factor to increase or flare the psoriasis complaints. So this was something which I found very much useful for my patients, and I found it may be useful for someone who is suffering with psoriasis out there. Do continue your medication, which generally suppresses your immune system. I don't want to get into the debate right now, but these are some things which really were found to help people in the research, and also for some of my patients as well. So yeah, that brings me to the end of this video. Hope this video was helpful. Till then, bye bye and have a great life. Bye.